Scientists put the blood of the young mouse, the one on the right, into his aging counterpart and found the elder on the left there performed better on tests of strength and memory, which is fascinating. Joining me now, senior medical correspondent Elizabeth Cohen. Elizabeth, you know, what are the old mice getting out of this from the young?
You know, when they tested them, they found that they could do mazes better, which speaks to memory. They found that they were stronger. They found that they could run on a treadmill. The old mouse could run on a treadmill just as long as the young mouse, as long as he had the younger mouse's blood, because they apparently actually do make treadmills for mice. Who knew, right? But it's amazing that they got those results, and they got them consistently through several different studies. And in one of the ways, I want to show you one of the ways, Martin, that they actually did the blood transfusion. One of the groups actually sewed a young mouse to an old mouse. They actually sewed them together, the gray old one and the white younger one, so that they shared a circulatory system. So I thought that was pretty interesting, that that's one way to get blood from one animal to another.
Right, not too practical in the human world, but right. But okay. So what is it in the blood? Do we know?
You know, they're not sure, but they think it might be a protein called GDF11. And GDF11 promotes new cell growth. And that's what's sort of a sign of being younger, is that there's more cell growth, it's faster. And so they think that protein may be what's going on. So in one of the studies, they didn't do the whole transfusion thing, they just gave them the protein. And that actually seemed to work pretty well just on its own.
So what do we do with this? How does this, you know, convert to the human side of things? And especially a lot of us who would say, boy, I'd love to feel younger.
Right. So are you already picking out your young person who you're going to get? You're looking around the studio.
It does sound a little spooky in the sense of, yeah, that I'd like some of your youngest blood, please.
That's right. 12 years old, please. You know, I would like to emphasize that this is a great day to be a mouse. This is not necessarily a great day to be a human. This may never work in humans. And one reason for that is that if they ever do try it, they may find that it causes, for example, cancer, because it promotes cell growth, or it may promote bad cell growth. It may promote cancer and tumors. So this may never, ever come to fruition. But they can maybe look at the principles of it. For example, this specific protein. Is there something they can do with this protein to, say, help stave off Alzheimer's or help stave off the muscle wasting that can happen to older people? So I know that you won't see two people sewn together. I feel pretty sure that we're never going to see that. But you may never see any of this. This may just be something that's fabulous for mice, won't work so well in humans.
Well, you know, there was that thing called vampires, which sort of worked on that premise.
Yeah, you know, maybe those vampires, maybe they were onto something, right? Maybe
we can only find them for study. Yeah.
Right.